And we're back!
I'm just gonna hang here.
As Rob laments to himself. Looks like Link's just gearing up to take a shit.
Just waiting for someone to pass by.
It lands on Fierre again.
Okay, guess I go up. Oh, yeah. I see. I see what's going on.
This is nice.
Yeah, this is just a really...
Imagine the view of the Earth from up here.
Yeah. This is just a really peaceful place. Patches of grass are lifting up bottom and everything from the ground in the wind. Oh, there's like a nice... Oh, hey. Local wildlife.
I think his tail's important.
Looks like it.
Argorok.
God, he does look like the Red Eyes Black Dragon.
I'll see you later.
Okay, bye. Love you.
Yeah, so there's the pillars.
Yeah.
I don't entirely remember everything about this fight. I just remember the pillars and grabbing him somehow.
Yeah, probably by the tail.
Probably from the pillars.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm wondering if I have to get up there before he's even gonna give me the time of day. I don't get out of bed for anyone on the ground. Okay, he's...
Oh, target him. There you go. Put on your iron boots, maybe.
Oh, maybe. Okay. Let's try that again. Oh, God. Oh. Oh, God. Okay, that was... That is timing.
Was that like a panic button push and it just happened to be right?
No, I definitely like knew what button I was pushing. It was just...
Yeah!
It's just better timing than I expected. It was very close, we'll say that.
You take your boots off and probably beat the shit out of his head or something.
Yeah.
Or his wings. They look like they don't have any...
Oh, God.
Well, I bet you it's just like, What boss is that? I don't even remember if it's Wind Waker or if it's Ocarina of Time, but there's a boss where you're basically just beating its armor off of it. I think it's Wind Waker.
Yeah, I think it probably is.
I think, yeah, because I remember you grapple something and then rocks fall on it and it cracks its armor off.
Okay.
Boop.
Ah, my dick!
Oh, yeah, now he's got a glowy spot on his back.
Okay. Oh, that was his tongue. Wasn't sure if it was his tongue or just, like, some tassels. Some nice little tassels.
He's mad.
Yeah, he's not loving this. Those goddamn plants!
I think they're there for you to assist you, though. So you can maneuver around.
I'll believe that when I see it. High enough. Nope. I definitely did not go up high enough.
Yeah, I'm thinking you want to get above him now and grapple the thing on his back. Yeah, he doesn't have the hook on his tail anymore.
Yeah. Now, can I
No, not I think you're quite. Gonna wanna grapple one of those plants pretty quick. Oh, not picking
oh.
up.
Oh! In mid-grapple! You ever eaten a grapple?
No, I have not.
They're a little weird.
Is that a real thing?
Yeah, it's an apple that's modified to taste like grape.
Oh, that sounds disgusting.
Yeah, well, it doesn't taste like actual grape, is the thing. It very much tastes like artificial grape.
No, you want to get on one of the plants.
Yeah, well...
Because that makes you high enough to...
Yeah, but I can't get high enough.
You probably want to climb on top of the pillar.
Oh, probably. Oh. Quickly.
Yeah, there you go. Now you're probably just going to try to circle around him or something.
Yeah.
You probably want to bait him to attack, and then he'll stop. There you go, like that. Because now he's going to sit there winding up, and you can get around him.
Maybe. Oh, God! Okay, let's try that again.
I drink a potion while you're on the ground.
Yeah.
Pretty intense. So you just keep going.
Yeah.
So I bet you'll hit a point where you'll be able to target him or something. There you go. Maybe. Try manually targeting him?
Maybe.
Yep. There you go. Now stab him.
Yeah.
And plummet. Oh my god.
Oh, this is so cool.
Now beat his tongue up or something, probably. Oh, maybe not.
Okay. That's fine.
Yeah, I remember this being a really cool fight.
There. And back. Oh my god. Come on, spit your fire.
Spit your hot fire.
Yeah. Yeah, throw out some sick verses.
Try sitting in one spot for just a second longer. There, now go.
Yep. Ah ha ha ha. I fooled you. You dumb, sweet dragon.
That I already can't remember the name of.
What was it, like Argorok?
Keep going.
Yeah.
I think he sits in one spot after he's finished attacking for long enough that you don't really need to...
Yeah. Oh, there he is. Gotcha.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it's like the part that where he's falling to the ground with me on the back that really gets me. Like, I can't believe I'm saying this. This music is not dramatic enough for that.
Here you go.
Yeah, dumbass dragon.
Dumbass sweet dragon.
You fucking cool idiot.
Keep going. Oh dear.
No.
He got smarter.
Oh shit. Yeah. He heard what we were saying about him. He took a college course in fighting little elf men.
Yeah, he changed. He moved to the other side, so I guess when he does that, you gotta change your direction.
Yeah. Man, he went to, like, Sate or something.
Sate doesn't have that high of standards. I go to Sate.
Oh, okay. I'm glad I waited.
For those of you who might not be Canadian or live in Calgary, Sate is the Southern Alberta Institute of Technology. Well, there you go.
Yeah.
Google it.
Throw up the logo. Let's get a sponsorship deal from them. In the episode where you say, they don't have that high of standards.
Get ready. I bet she's going to turn around pretty quick.
Probably.
Yeah, here he goes. Yeah, there you go. That way. Way to go, Rob.
Yeah, hope you're signed up for that 200 level course. That introductory shit ain't cutting it.
Yes.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. My mouth! It hurts so bad!
I'm just gonna keep going up and up and up.
Until he explodes in space. This is gonna be amazing.
I like picturing just once they do a thing like that, and Onuma totally trolls you by having the heart piece like shatter when it hits the ground. So you don't get one. Oh.
Dumbass! Dumbass! You did it! It's the fourth shard!
Excuse me, did you not see that incredible beatdown I just gave to that dragon? At least get my name right.
Now we have them all! Hey, dumbass! Damn it.
Dumbass? You dumbass!
Hey, dumbass! The words of the sages. Do you remember them?
There once was a man from Nantucket.
Only the true ruler of the Twilight can destroy the Mirror of Twilight. Zant could only break the Mirror of Twilight into shards. He couldn't utterly shatter it. That's proof of his false kingship.
I wish we had stuff like that in the real world. You can't be prime minister unless you can pull the sword from the stone. It's like, oh, sorry, I know you got elected, but it is a stain right in there. You're really gonna fuck up in these next 4 years.
Oh, man. Imagine how that could be totally manipulated, though. You could have, like, the bottom of the sword be exposed underground, and you could have, like, just some really buff guy holding on to it from the bottom.
I'm assuming, like, in this case, magic does exist.
Oh, okay.
Magic that can judge people's hearts and future actions.
Dumbus, we have to hurry to the mirror chamber!
Otherwise, yeah, the Prime Minister would just be the buffest man in the land.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, Prime Minister of Canada!
Man, remember in the 1990s when Eric Lindros was Prime Minister?
After all, a fake is a fake, and no matter how much you dress it up, the real thing always wins. So I'll get your hurt, you piece of shit. Come on.
What are you waiting for? You
fucker.
That dragon's not coming back. You're not getting an autograph.
You're not gonna fight it a second time. Hey! Listen!
And then that's when the dragon's head pops up out of the portal and you do have to fight it again. Except it's way cooler. Hey. Oh, okay, I thought it was still a cutscene.
No, that's why I was like,
grab the heart, you stupid idiot.
Well, I mean, it was framed like a cutscene.
It was.
I'll get you out of here. You sure there's nothing else you need to do?
Probably.
You need to go get that dragon's autograph.
Oh shit, I left the oven on. I left Yuka's oven on. Yes, I do want to save.
How much total playtime have we had now? Once this saves, it'll tell us. 37 hours.
All right.
Yeah, I think that's all we gotta do here in the sky place. All
right.
So, out of curiosity, go back to the... Go back to the store and just see if you can talk to Uku.
Oh, yeah.
See what Uku says. The resistance it's of the water and swim. The wind. It's too windy to swim.
I mean, that is possible.
Yeah, it is.
But it does sound strange. It's like when you hear about a game played indoors. It's like, oh, it's been canceled because of the snow.
Yeah. Because when you think about it, it's like, oh, people probably can't get there.
Yeah.
But it's like, it's an indoor game and it's been canceled because of the weather.
Yeah. Actually, there was one game in the 80s. The New Jersey Devils played, and I forget how many people came, but it was definitely in, like, the double digits, because the snow was so bad.
Holy shit.
And so what happened was they actually, like, went around, gave them, like, free tickets or something, and inducted them into this club that just meets up every so often.
Really?
Yeah.
Thank you so much, adventurer. Gracious, you've done so much for us, adventurer. I hope you'll come to see us again sometime.
You know, I'm just gonna live here. Live with the Yuka.
It's like, maybe not.
Did they hear me? I want to look cool in front of the Yuka. Oh, yeah, just shift my weight all chill like. Do they think I'm cool yet? Do they think I'm cool yet? Is that shopkeeper talking about how cool I am?
Just in their language, like, what the fuck is this human still doing? Well, I guess we should head back to the surface. The Uka don't want us.
Oh, man. Goodbye, my best friends. And that includes the girl who I just went on this huge journey to restore the memory of.
Goodbye to her?
No. No, when I say the Uka are my best friends, I mean, like, even compared to her who I've known for so long. That was badly phrased.
Swimming!
Yeah.
Who doesn't love some good old swimming?
That's right. Swimming in the sky.
Oh, I think you gotta use your claw shot to get in it.
Yeah. Just like God intended.
It is a Metal Gear.
That's when it cuts to Link, like, one of those witch Halloween ornaments you see. It's just, like, a couple legs and a broomstick sticking out of the ground.
Also, you landed near Fier's little area, so...
Yeah.
I like to imagine everything that we dropped did fall down here.
You know, go over, he's just in, like, a body cast.
You idiot! Are you done up there?
So I guess now it's warped that mirror chamber.
Oh, yeah. Let's go. And that was...
the right at the top. Yeah. Well, the down one.
Oh.
The top.
Oh, the top of this.
Yeah.
Right.
Plot.
My God.
It's like Legos, only simpler. Look, there's not even any crack lines.
It's beautiful. That rock just landed on the mirror.
No! We have to defeat Evil Boulder!
Some call our realm a world of shadows, but that makes it sound unpleasant.
It's just a realm of a weird imp man who's trying to destroy everything. Never mind.
The twilight there holds a serene beauty. You have seen it yourself as the sun sets on this world. Bathed in that light, all people were pure and gentle.
Except that warlord, but whatever.
But things changed once that foul power pervaded the world.
Oh, that's you.
It was all our doing. Oops. We overestimated our abilities as sages and attempted to put an end to Ganondorf's evil magic. I hope you can find it in yourself to forgive our carelessness.
Why do they all have pedestals like their chest pieces?
You interrupted something. We were playing human chess. Oh, Twilight Princess.
Midna's the Twilight Princess.
What? So you knew?
We're sages.
We're wise beyond comprehension.
You know, except for, you know, the occasional whatever, you know.
As a ruler who fled her people, I'm hardly qualified to forgive you.
God, he's so cool.
Yeah.
I love his design.
Now you are adorable.
Look at her sweet hair.
Damn.
That made her very happy.
In our world, we've long believed that the hero would appear as a divine beast.
Like me.
That's why when I found you, I thought I could use you, Dumbus.
I thought it was going to go like total Grinch and like have the same smile.
And I only cared about returning our world to normal. I didn't care what happened to the world of light. Not at all.
That's fine, Midna. I didn't care what happened to the world of Twilight. I mean...
But after witnessing the selfless lengths that Princess Zelda and you have gone to, your sacrifices,
your full pouty lips,
I now know, in the bottom of my heart, that I must save this world too. There is no other way. If we can just defeat Zant, the curse on me will dissolve, and we may be able to revive Zelda. Let's go, Dumbus. For Zelda. For all of this world.
You pound it.
Yeah, alright.
He didn't pound it. How disrespectful.
Total beta move.
We've still got a few minutes left in this episode. Why don't you enter the Twilight Realm and get a sneak peek there, Rob?
Yeah, let's take a look. Beam me in, Scotty.
The Palace of Twilight.
This is cool.
Listen, Dumbus. Can I ask you one selfish favor? The one selfish favor I've asked this entire time?
No.
Regardless of what my reasons may have been, I once abandoned this world. I left behind the Twilight, those who had followed me, who considered me their ruler. Even now, as they remain here, suffering, they believe that help will come for this world. But if they were to see that the line, but if they were to see that the only help for them was a hideous little imp, don't you think that they'd feel let down?
You're right. See ya.
It's only for a little bit longer. Do you mind if I continue to hide in your shadow while you're in human form? I'm sorry.
Why? It's not like it's any skin off our nose.
Yeah. Hey guys. What's up? What's happening?
Wait! This guy isn't an enemy, Dumbus! They might look different, but they're inhabitants of this world. They're my people. Zant. How could he?
He, like, warped their appearances. I think you can talk to them. I don't remember.
Yeah?
Oh, maybe not. You can once they're fixed, I think.
Just a bunch of chubby little shield heads. Isn't that right, Chubbo?
Don't worry, the things that have those heads that you know and love already,
yeah,
they're everywhere in here. You know, actually, when I was a kid, that one over there in the distance used to freak me out. To the right.
Oh, the tall one.
Yeah.
The one that is absolutely horrifying.
There's another one on the right side it's just the way it looks from, like, if you turn the camera, just seeing him standing in the distance, that used to freak me out.
Like, he's got kind of a re-dead posture to him.
Yeah.
Or Shaggy.
Scooby-Doo?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Remember that episode of Scooby-Doo where they revealed Shaggy's a re-dead?
And he's always high on pot.
That's why he's always hungry.
Yeah.
He's trying to restrain himself from, like, sucking human souls by just eating gigantic sandwiches.
Well, before I tackle this place next time on the show, I'm gonna go back and get some items.
Cool.
For you guys, the episode will probably be either, I don't know, tomorrow or Monday if this is a Friday. But, for us, it'll be our next recording session, so...
5 years from now.
I wanted Rob to see the Twilight Realm. Let's go to Castletown. Fuck it.
I can't remember. Did I already compare Malomar to Urban Outfitters?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Probably. I probably did. Both of them feel like I'm in hell.
Hey, Rudy, how's it going?
See ya.
Mr. Dumbus, wait!
It's your favorite character, Rob.
Oh, boy. You know, I like the idea that Link doesn't even consciously change into a wolf when he comes. It's just the mailman. You can't approach me like that! He waves his hand.
Greetings, Mr. Dumbus. I have come to deliver a letter. There is a letter for you, Dumbus. Three letters, in fact.
God, I never noticed the little song.
Oh, yeah. Well, my business is concluded. Onward to mail!
Let's see, you sent us some letters.
What kind of mailman is this? Like, imagine if you're just walking around downtown. You're just gonna go to the museum or something. Some guy comes up to you. Wait! It's your mail! What? I have a box for that at my house. What are you doing here?
So, this one's just telling us that we have the new Star Game we can do. Maybe we'll do that next time, too.
Oh, yeah. Hey, kid.
Oh, it's from... Oh. Uku Jr. wanted to send us a letter.
Oh.
But all he knew how to do was say, wow, kid, awesome. Agatha had a dream last night.
Oh, I bet you did.
Butterflies surrounded Agatha and lifted her up to the sky.
God.
As she waved to the people below in Castletown, she could see so many people, some waving back, others staring wide-eyed. Agatha flew in a big circle above Hyrule Field, and the butterflies formed into a bed beneath her and said, let's play again. Soon they faded away and she woke up in her own bed. Agatha wants so badly to fly in the sky.
Ugh, that's some Maslank ass bullshit. Both of you who got the joke, I think, are really gonna appreciate that.
Oh, this is from Shad.
Oh. I'm going back to the sanctuary in Kakariko Village to see if I can't find another lead. I certainly hope that if you find any more information, you will share it with me post-haste. The Dream Chaser, Shad.
Yeah.
God, he's become a hippie. I'm off searching the realms of consciousness with acid. Have you ever seen The Trip?
No, I have not.
Oh, it's great.
We gotta watch Idiocracy.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Rob, we've only got like one more recording session and then we're finally done this game.
Oh, man.
We'll be saying goodbye to Hyrule until Breath of the Wild comes out.
And all the dogs.
Sad.
Before Don't we leave. Worry, well, this will cheer you up. The happiest place in Hyrule, Malamart.
God, it is like Urban Outfitters.
We'll see you guys next time as we enter the Twilight Realm.
I forgot about the creepy black and white portrait of Malo there.
Ugh. And the statue.
Yeah, honestly, the statue does not bother me nearly as much as, like, the Silent Hill-ass photo of him.
I could have sworn there was, like... a reference to Breath of the Wild in here somewhere.
Huh.
In the HD remake, they put it in. Something. I don't remember. Yeah, I don't remember. Oh, wait, is it on this? I don't know. We'll see you guys next time.
Yeah,
wait.
Look it up on Did You Know Gaming.
Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. How do I go first person? I think that might be it. That little picture.
Oh, like sitting on the desk there?
Yeah. Maybe there's another one.
I know it's suitably lush and green.
I know it's a picture. I don't know. It must be that one. Eh. Yes, it is. Because that's okay. In the 2014 E3 trailer, that's the scene you see, and then you see Link come running down the road on the horse. And the guardians chasing him.
Mm.
Cool. Figured it out. We'll see you guys next time.
Don't look it up on Did You Know Gaming. Those guys are assholes.
Rob wanted to join, and they said, fuck off.
I tried to share my gaming facts. I said, Did you know Mario has a mustache because of his weak upper lip? And they said, it's not a real fact. And then I swore revenge.
We'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.